Sir, bukas quad kum uli tayo. Confirm ba na dadalaw si dating Pangulong Rodrigo Duterte?
Siya, meron. Galing tanong mo, Vic. Kala ko dito lang tayo muna sa property. Sige. Hindi. We already sent out invitations. Nireiterate lamang natin. Kasi nga yung dati na pinadala natin, kundi ako nagkakamali, during our second or third Quadcom hearing yan, napadala natin yung mga invitation yan. Pero walang tugon. Walang. That's why we reiterated. Maaring hindi natanggap, kaya nga itong invitation na ito, nagpadala tayo ulit.
Natanggap po ba?
Wala pa kaming feedback. I think we course it through the PNP na mapadala ito para mas mabilis. So. Okay.
Hopefully. No. Good morning po, good congressman. Earl po from IVC 13. Sir, on another topic, sa press con po ni Vice President Sara Duterte and over the weekend, ilan po sa mga House leaders natin na nagpahayag ng kanilang pagkabahala sa ilang mga statement na binitawan ng ating Vice Presidente. Any comments or reaction po on this one, sir? Thank you.
Ayong sa akin talaga, gusto kong tanungin kung okay lang ba siya eh. Nag-aalala po talaga ako eh. Pero the statements were not even, for me, hindi na siya political eh. Parang it's a question of kultura. Nasa kultura ba nating mga Pilipino yung mga ganyan na statements? Ganyan ba tayo pinalaki? Ganyan ba kapaligiran natin? So talagang nanlilisik. Parang galit na galit sa mundo. So yun lang kaya talagang kinestyon ko po eh kung talagang okay ba siya. So yun.
Hello.
Congressman Rog, your comment?
I have to agree with si Congressman Ortega. I think it's a cultural issue, especially yung relation to dun sa discretion yung bangkay. And I think most of the people have already complained po, no? I think it doesn't really involve any comment on our part as congressmen, and we leave it siguro to the people to decide on how they would see that as qualities of a leader.
We'd like to acknowledge also the arrival of Congressman Jay Kung Hoon. Good morning, Congressman Jay, and you can also ask direct your questions to him.
Sir, follow up.
Following up with that lang po, some of the young guns leaders requested psychological evaluation for the Vice President, sir. Would this be firm or may re-recommend na daw po ba tayo na?
Suggestion lang naman yun. Hindi naman, una-una, hindi rin naman ako pwedeng mag-recommenda at wala rin akong kilala. Kasi so far, parang okay pa naman ako. Pero the people have seen the interview. So parang may something. Ewan ko. Oo. Parang punong-puno ng galit. Saka parang yung mga lumabas sa ating mga pahayagan. Para talagang parang hindi ko alam kung may meltdown o may problema na nangyayari right before our eyes during the press con.
Sir?
Yung kasi yung yun ang lalabas sa news eh, juicy eh. So, dito naman sa Quadcom, from the start, we've been evidence-based. Kung ano po ang mga lumalabas sa aming legislative inquiry, very clear po yun na yun po ang lumalabas at napapalabas po sa social media. But again, baka it's another diversionary tactic.
Sir, sabi ni Attorney Sal Panelo kanina sa interview, hindi naman daw publicly sinabi ni VP Sara yon. Parang sa group chat lang daw yon. Doon sa sinabi na huhukay niyo, yung paghukay.
Hindi, magaling talaga siya sa ganun. Yung ano, kasi siya yung official interpreter dati, nung dating Pangulo. So malamang ginagawa na rin niya dito ngayon.
Sir, you mentioned parang punong-puno ng galit.
Pwede bang?
Ay, yes. Sorry.
Punong-puno ng galit talaga.
Yes. Why do you think po? Bakit po sa tingin ninyo ganun yung nangyari kay, and you even mentioned Kong Ortega na parang may meltdown or may problema na nangyari. Why do you think po na nagkaganan?
Well, siguro sa nangyari sa ating Vice President, nagkakaroon siya ng, I think she's being overwhelmed by anger and hate. Pag ang isang tao ay sobrang-sobrang galit, nawawala siya sa sense of decency, sa aking paningin. And sometimes, yung how you manage yung hate sa yung katawan at saka yung nasasaktan ka, it's also a test of your character. Diba? How you manage these things, it's a test of your character. So in the case of the Vice President, eh, lumalabas po yung flaw sa kanyang character kasi natatalo ng kanyang galit. Yun po yung aking nakikita as far as this representation is concerned. Maraming salamat po.
Sir, ay, hello po. Apa, parang ang hugot po ni VP Sara, yung ginagawang pagkalkal doon sa kanyang confidential fund, yung paggamit ng pondo ng kanyang office ng Kamara. So ang House of Representatives po ba kayo, magbabago ba kayo or mag-a-adjust ba kayo, maghihinay-hinay ba kayo sa pag-iimbestiga sa kanyang paggamit po ng pondo?
Sa gana ng amin, the performance of one's duty should be the primordial consideration. Trabaho po namin yun eh. And therefore, dapat walang let up to show what really happened and so far as the confidential funds of the Office of the Vice President and the Department of Education when she was still the Secretary. Kasi pag magbibigay po kami ng leeway, hindi po na yata in accordance with our mandate. Ganun po ang paningin namin doon.
Okay. Sir, before that, we'd like to acknowledge the presence also of our Senior Deputy Speaker, Dong Gonzales. Good morning. Okay. Continue.
Sir, yung dito sa nakita nyo na, sabi nyo nga may meltdown, kakaiba, yung galit, ganito, ganyan. May nakikita ba kayo na parang signs ng psychological incapacity dun sa nangyari kay Vice President dun sa presko niya?
I think we would not be in a proper position to determine that. Siguro, it would be recommended that she should see a psychologist or a psychiatrist. Kasi sila po ang expert dito eh. Hindi po kami.
Sir, sorry. Good morning po. Hindi lang po si Pangulong Marcos and former President Apo Marcos yung kumbaga tinira ni VP Sara. Meron din po kasi siyang binanggit laban din po kay Speaker Romualdez na sinabi niyang embarrassment daw po ang ating House Speaker. As House Leaders, ano pong masasabi po ninyo dun sa pahayo po na yun?
That's her opinion. It's not the opinion of 120 million Filipinos. Di po ba? And she is entitled to her opinion.
Sir, follow-up lang. Kasi yung embarrassment po is stemming from doon sa sinabi ni VP Sara na tumanggap daw po ng suhol si Speaker Romualdez. Do you know anything about this? Or what can you say about this po?
Suhol saan yun?
She did not expound or elaborate po yung tungkol doon sa susunod daw niyang press con.
Pero, so we will not be commenting on that kasi hindi naman namin alam kung ano suhol yan.
Hayaan mo po muna mag-expound siya. Then we'll answer the issue about it. And second, siguro, I'd just like to add, no? Just like what we have done with the Office of the Vice President, giving due courtesy to that office, ang unsolicited advice po is, the Vice President should also give due courtesy to the Office of the President and, of course, to the late Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Yun lang po. Kasi well in fact, for the record, napakaganda na pong binigay naming courtesy sa kanya nung she was invited during the Good Government Committee hearing. Well, in fact, he was allowed to speak while not taking her oath. So, yun lang po, unsolicited advice. Just give due courtesy to the office of the president.
Well, Congressman Gonzales po, no? Well, regarding dun sa Suhol, di po namin alam yun, diba? Ang pagkaalam ko po from the day of the campaign, ang kasama po ni Vice President Sara ay si Speaker Martin Romualdez. Alam niyo po, sa totoo lang, pag nag-uusap kami ni Speaker, kasi po may survey na lumabas na mababasa sa Pampanga during those times, ang pinakiusap ni Speaker Romualdez sa amin na kung pwede tulungan si Vice President Sara sa Pampanga. Kasi nga, may kandidatong Kapampangan doon, si Kiko Pangilinan. At mataas si Kiko Pangilinan kasi Kapampangan. So, we work out po namin yun. At from day one up to the proclamation, kasama po si Speaker Martin Romualdez. Ang kwento, lahat po, siya po ang nagmamalasakit kay Vice President Sara. Kaya nagtataka po ako, biglang bumaligtad, na kung hindi sa'yo, Speaker Martin Romualdez, hindi ako naging Vice President. Meron pong statement ganyan nung napanood po natin yun. Kaya sana po, hindi po natin alam kung ano ang nasa isip ni Vice President Sara. At yun man lang sabihin mo na uukayin mo yung tatay at itatapon mo sa West Philippine Sea, ako po isang nasaktan bilang anak. Kung ako po si Senator Amy Marcos, sinabi sa tatay ko yun, palagay ko, hindi na po kami pwedeng magkita at mag-usap sa panahon na yun. Sasabihin ko, ibang klase na to, ibang usapan na to. So sana po walang ganyang usapan. At yung ganyang naririnig kong mga salita, salita pag umiinom sa kanto, sa barangay, paglasing na, biruan lang yun, di ba? Pero walang ganyang, pero wala pong ganyan. Medyo, ako po, honestly, after yung press conference niya, meron po, nasa palasyo po ako, birthday po ni E.S. Bersamin. Pero gusto kong sabihin sa presidente, pero hindi ko po nasabi, kasi baka ayaw po niyang marinig yun. Pero deep inside in my heart, ako po talaga nasaktan doon sa sinabi niya. Because I'm also, anak po ako eh. Hindi na po ako makakakita ng tatay. Isa lang po ang tatay ko. Tapos sasabihin po sa tatay ko yun, nuukain niya at itatapon niya. Palagay ko napakasakit po nun. So bilang isang Kristiyano, bilang isang batang pinalaki sa maayos, palagay ko foul po yun. Salamat po.
Thank you. I would like to acknowledge also the presence of the Chairman of the Committee on Human Rights, our co-chair sa Quadcom, Congressman Benny Abante. Good morning.
Mr. Chair, in addition to that, na sinabi po ni SDS, ano, alam nyo, kahit pagbalik-balik na din natin ang mundo, yung ating pong former president, si Ferdinand Marcos Sr., malaki po nagawa niya sa bansang Pilipinas. Kahit sabihin na natin na inakusahan siya na diktador, at napatalsik siya ng ating pong mga kababayan. Pero at the end of the day, we have to accept that he made a lot of things for the Filipino people. At yung pong pagsasabi na huhukayin siya at itatapos sa West Philippine Sea. Medyo parang sa mga nagmamahal, no, lalo na yung mga Marcos loyalists, no, na nakita natin na talagang pinaglalaban yung ating pundating Pangulo, napakasakit po nun. And we have to be careful with our statements, no? Kasi hahabulin tayo ng panahon at pagkakataon. Like for example, yung ginagawa po na statements ng ating pundating Pangulo, si Rodrigo Roa Duterte, ngayon hinahabol na po siya ng sitwasyon. We hope that this will not happen to the Vice President. But definitely, somebody might file a case against her. At nobody can prevent that dahil nga wala namang immunity ang ating pong Vice President. Masakit po yung mga ganitong klaseng salita na hindi naman po dapat nasabihin na nanggaling sa isang opisyal ng ating bansa.
Sir, clarification on the invitation kay former President Duterte. 18 pa po yun, October 18, yung reiteration ng invitation ninyo. Meron na po bang feedback from the PNP kung na-deliver man lang po doon sa bahay itong, at may nag-receive nitong invitation? And second question, kung meron ding reiteration ng invitation kina Senator Bongo and Senator De La Rosa?
Well, dun sa previous invitation that we sent, I think, kundi nga ako nagkakamali, during the second or third Quadcom hearing yun, open-ended yun until we conduct these hearings. Open invitation po yung aming invitation. We only had to reiterate kasi para matagal-tagal na rin yun. This is already the 9th and going to be the 10th hearing of the joint committee hearing. So that's why we had to send and reiterate the invitation.
Pero I understand may sulat din po kayo kay CIDG Chief
yes, we
to
did.
Ensure na may magre-receive, may feedback na po.
As we speak, wala pa. Wala pa kaming nakukuhang feedback. But we had to course it through the PNP kasi sila ho'y nakakalam ng address doon sa area. And we always do that naman every time we send out invitations to personalities outside of Metro Manila.
Kakong, magandang umaga po. Habol ko lang po, hingi lang po na reaction doon sa parallel investigation na gagawin ng Senate dun sa EJK tsaka drug war.
Well, kami, I'm sure narinig nyo na yung aming opinion tungkol dyan. Eh, kami, sang-ayon din kami dyan. No? In fact, mas maganda nga na magkaroon din ng isang parallel investigation dahil wala namang hung prohibition sa aming rules. And because of merong ganyang klaseng parallel investigation, we do expect that in sync ang lower house at saka ang Senate dito sa usapin tungkol sa EJK. We really have to come up with a law, no, para matigil at hindi na mangyari po itong mga ganitong klaseng extrajudicial killings. Now, my opinion, I'm sure my colleagues here, my co-chairs, meron din silang sariling opinion. Ang opinion ko, eh kung merong ang Senate, meron din ang House, eh ba't hindi dala natin pag-isahin, parang bicam. Ang dating, isang joint committee hearing, nandyan ang Kongreso, nandyan ang Senado, at nandyan yung ating investigation. No? Mas, I think mas malawak, mas komprehensibo, at syempre, mas maraming mga intelligent questions na maitatanong ang mga membro nitong committee ito. So it has to be some sort of a joint. Every time may SONA, di ba, meron tayong joint session. Ito, ganun din gawin natin. Mas maganda sa tingin ko. I don't know. Sa tingin ko, priority ito ng mga mambabatas. Eh. Kaya yung kung uunahin nila yung personal na interest sa pamamagitan ng pagsabi na may kampanya kasi kaya wala sila, eh, isa sa kanilang mandato at obligasyon ay itong ating ginagawang conducting an investigation in aid of legislation. Yan po ang aming trabaho. Produkto ng aming committee ay pinag-aaralan at pinag-iisipan po yan.
Saka lalo na, Mr. Chairman, no, para mapabilis, remember 2 weeks ago nag-file kami ng dalawang bill, no? Yung pong declaring EJK as a heinous crime at yung isa ng pag-stop ng POGO. Now, kung hindi magiging sinking yung upper and lower house pagdating sa ganitong klase ng investigation at bills na pinal natin, by December ang order ng Presidente tigil. Kung hindi natin mag-aaprubahan yung POGO bill na we filed, together with the with the upper house, eh, mababaliwala po yung ating pong ginawang submission or filing of that two bills. Mas maganda po para mapabilis po yung ating pong kilos ay magsama na po ang Senado at ang Kongreso.
Habol ko lang po.
By the way, ipopropose pa namin yan ha, kung ano ang masasabi ng ating Senate President at saka ng ating Speaker of the House. No? It was just an idea na tinitingnan natin kasi para masabi na impartial itong investigation na to dahil tayong lahat, bawat Pilipino, ay naniniwala na kinukundina natin ang mga pagpatay. Wala po siguro magsasabi dito na natutuwa sila mayroong pinapatay. Diba? So dahil nga ganito kalawak itong usapin na ito at itong usapin na ito ay isang usapin of national importance, therefore, ang Kongreso, ang Senado at ang lower house ay dapat magtipon para talakayin itong usapin na ito at gumawa ng solusyon nang sa ganun ay hindi na maulit ito.
Habol ko lang po, ibabalik ko lang ng konti doon sa kanina. Bukod po ba doon sa pagbili ng lupa, meron po bang ginamitan ng ibang peking birth certificate para makakuha halimbawa ng gun license tsaka ng driver's license? May ganun po bang nakita yung Quadcom?
Hello, lahat po. It all started with LCR and PSA. Pag may PSA na po, papasok na po yung LTO. Lahat na, and that includes passports. So lahat ng mga government IDs and passports, doon talaga nagsimula doon sa LCR at saka sa PSA.
So meron pong na-discover na ginamit yung pagkuha ng gun license, ginamit yung peking birth certificate?
I think sa case ni Tony Young. Kay Tony Young.
Recommendation yata ni SP yan, ano? And of course we respect that dahil sila naman po ay bound by their rules eh. Ganun din kami dito sa House. Kasi hindi pwedeng siguro naisip nila na hindi pwedeng si Senator Bato because he's being implicated, no? Bilang chairman ng Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs sa Senate. That's why siguro naisip ni SP na ilagay sa Blue Ribbon at si Senator Coco Pimentel mag-delete.
Sir?
Hi sir, good morning po. Rose po sa UNTV. Rose. Sir, we're preparing two scenarios tomorrow for the Quadcom hearing. Kung mag-a-attend si dating Presidente Duterte, how do we prepare for it? At kung hindi siya dadalo, what do we expect? Do we have new witnesses to present that will corroborate the reward system of the anti-drug war?
That's a good, tough question. But the chairman of the Committee on Human Rights will be able to answer that. Congressman Benny.
Magandang umaga po. Sorry sa pagiging late. Anyway, bilang chairman po ng Committee on Human Rights, noon pa, nais na namin imbitahan ang ating dating Pangulo to appear. No? Not a person na inaakusahan namin, kundi bigyan ng linaw talaga ang lahat ng mga bagay nito. Particularly yung EJK. Pagkat binanggit naman ni Colonel Espinido at ng mga ibang mga kapulisan natin na talagang may EJK. Ngayon, kung halimbawa hindi makakadalo ang Pangulo, ine-expect namin siyang dumalo sapagkat sinabi naman niya sa media na if he is invited, ay darating siya. Kaya palagay ko sa akin po, walang pagdududa na he might come. Kung di siya tumating, meron pa po kaming mga witnesses na talagang magsasalita patungkol sa mga bagay na ito.
Charan, palagdag ko lang po. Actually, yung invitation ng Presidente nung nakaraan pa yan, and to invite him once again in tomorrow's hearing is just normal, no? He's just one of the resource person that was invited in previous hearing. Now, kung question of preparations with regards to proceedings, I think yung preparation is still normal. because we treat the former president as one of the resource person that will shed light on the issue of AJK. So wala pong magbabago.
If ever he appears po tomorrow, ano po yung security na ipapatupad po natin? And will he get the first part of the hearings? Siya po ba muna yung pagsasalitain po natin? And what questions we will ask?
First, question of security, that's not us but the Sergeant at Arms, now in coordination with the PNP. Second, if he will be the first or the last or in the middle, sabi ko na nga, we will treat him as part of the resource person. So, depende po yan sa mga members, no, na magtatanong. And third question of what are those questions, let us see tomorrow what will happen during the hearing. Well,
dagdagan ko lang din, no, na of course, we will afford him the courtesy due to a former president. No? Eh, alam nyo naman, dito sa Quadcom, nire-respeto naman natin yung rights ng ating mga resource persons at ng ating mga witnesses. Taliwas dyan sa iniisip ng iba sa pagbabati ko sa amin na we do not daw respect the individual rights of our witnesses as well as our resource persons. No, of course they have the all the right. No, that we will extend to them. Kasi lalo na yan, na dati pong pangulo si former President Duterte. So definitely we will respect him as a person and respect his former office as the President of the Republic of the Philippines.
Let me add, no, sa akin naman, more than asking any educated question, we would like to listen to his educated answer. Ibig sabihin, we're willing to listen. Di ba? I mean, for him to explain to us yung war on drugs, we're willing to listen. For him to explain to us why is it necessary on the war on drugs that more than 20,000 people were killed, we are willing to listen. Oo. We're willing to listen na sinabi niya several times na patayin ang mga drug pushers. For example, we're willing to listen kung bakit niya sinabi yan. We're willing to listen na yung kanya mga binanggit na pinapatay, na embolden ang ilang mga pulis na gawin ang hindi natin, na hindi dapat gawin. We're willing to listen. We're willing to listen to him. Ha? Nasabihin niya, nagkaroon ba ng due process bilang chairman ng Committee on Human Rights? What I'm concerned about ito, nagkaroon pa ng due process? Nagkaroon ba na tinatawag natin sa konstitusyon na binigyan ng pagkakataon kahit mga suspect yan na hindi natin binibilang na mga criminal unless proven guilty? Bilang ang ating dating Pangulo ay piskal, naniniwala po siya sa due process. Naniniwala po siya na dapat bigyan ng pagkakataon ang mga suspect, kahit mga drug lord pa yan. We're willing to listen. We're willing to listen kung bakit more than 7,000 ang mga pinatayan ng mga drug pushers sa mga liit. Pero yung mga malalaking drug lords, buhay pa hanggang ngayon. That is what we would like to know.
Sir, sorry, follow-up lang. Kasi sa mga social media feed or post po ng mga supporters ng Duterte camp, his attendance may lead to contempt. Yung pong respect that the Quadcom will accord the former president, is that enough assurance for him not to be contempt?
The committee personally, I cannot assure that. It's up to him to be present tomorrow, and it's up to his answers and his actuation during the hearing. So, for me, sabi ko na nga, hindi ko pwedeng pangunahan ng dating Pangulo. Oh, let us see what will happen tomorrow. But one thing for sure, we'll afford him the due courtesy, his office should be afforded.
Sir?
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 Sir? Sorry. Sir?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, follow-up ko lang yung sa mga Chinese na may title.
meron ba kung may narinig ako if I, baka mali lang ako, Tony Yang, the brother of Michael Yang, kasi meron ding ID Tai Yang. ID Tai Yang is same as Tony Yang.
No, no, no. Iba yan. Magkaiba yan.
But this
ID... ID Tai Yang, yung Chinese name niya is Jia Jing Yang.
Ah, okay. Pero related ba to sa kay Michael Yang and Tony Yang, sir?
Si Edith Tayang is related by business associations.
As business associate.
Yeah. But
Michael
of course, si Tony
Yang,
Tony Yang is related to Michael Yang, the brother of Michael Yang.
So, itong si ID Tayang is business associate ni Tony Yang. Tama,
no,
sir?
No, ni Michael Yang.
Ah, Michael Yang. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir. I just like
to. Sir? Kagaya po nung nangyari sa good government na hearing, hindi po tumayo si VP Sara para mag-take ng oath. Granting po pumunta po si former president at hindi rin po tumayo para mag-take ng oath.
Again, as I've said, I cannot answer about it, but we have to stick in our rules. What is our rules should be followed during committee hearings. And let us see tomorrow.